Okay, let's select greed. And we're gonna slide him over, slide this over just a little bit so we can have it almost side by side with the head. Now this is a really, really rough little quick sketch. I'm not too familiar with the character, but I know it's an anime character. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to download the image. Okay, I see it's from Full Metal Alchemist. And I'm going to save this to the desktop. And I'm going to make a new one of these. So I can pop it here. Go to image, and I'm going to go, I need to expand this just a little bit so I can open the image. Go to desktop. And now I have that reference. This is the reference that I originally used. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Okay, so what I'm going to do is create the material for this using this same skin tone. I think I'll choose somewhere in the middle. Alright, so let's get started. Let me jump over here. Let's see if I can get the material to show up. Of course not. Nice if you can get that to show up. Unfortunately, I don't know how to get this to show what it should show. Alright, so let's go ahead and start this. Let's start here in this view. I'm going to go ahead and bump up the overall mesh resolution by adding a multi-res. And let's see how dense that is. Okay, it's not showing. Let's try that. Go to scope mode. All right, so I think we're going to just do the neck and the shoulders. Okay, I feel like the symmetry is not on and my screencast keys is not on. Alright. Alright, so let's go out of this. Wait a minute. Let's go here. Shape. Apply base. Alright. And then we're gonna apply this. Wait a minute, why is it? Or do I not get a apply? Oh, because I'm in edit mode. Alright, so now let's go to this scope mode. We're going to go to remesh and start here. Let's hide these other things. And they're just visually in the way. Trying to do this one relatively fast is why I'm jumping into a level of detail. I normally don't jump in. I'm trying to do this quick because I got something I need to go run to get some work done on my car, and I want to see if I can knock this out in way less time than I normally do. So I'm kind of jumping ahead here for speed purposes. Normally I would block this out. Spend more time doing that. But this is a typical head, so I figured once I get the shape, this guy doesn't have any ears. I just realized that. So you can see once you start getting used to sculpting, you can sometimes skip steps to move the progress along faster. It's not advisable if you are trying to build up the level of detail, but as you can see, even with me adding this, it's still pretty low as far as the resolution. Even though you see all these tries, it seems like it's way more than it really is. So right now I'm just pushing and pulling stuff around to try to get the shape I want. Alright, let's go here to the front view. I'm going to use the draw brush, draw sharp, because that one tended to give me, I think it's using dots. No, it's not using dots, it's using stabilized stroke. What I tend to do is once I have all the resolution in, I turn Dyne Topo off so I can come out of that mode and start working with adding the details. And I'm going to turn off this wireframe shortly because that's not going to be as helpful as I will need it to be. I'll go back in the dining table, add a little bit more detail. We'll jump up to 6. Okay, this is not doing anything for me. That might be too high. Let's go in between that. 6, 9, we'll say about 7. 6 and 9, 7.5. I think we got enough detail for now. Let's turn off this wireframe. Smooth out some of this. Feels like this can still be a little higher, but that should be good enough for me to work with. I always leave room for more. This neck looks like it can be wider here. So we're gonna go here and make this wider. let's save this. Alright, let's do this. We're gonna go here and plug fill this. So we're gonna go to constant. Nope. We need to go to 30. We want it to be higher than that. Go 45. All right, that's good enough. For now. Let's go to the wireframe. So first thing we need to do is get this hose together. Nose is pointed down. Kind of a gnarl. So I'm going to add the eyes and the teeth in just a second. All think those would be clay strips. I just had to have a little bit more detail. And it shouldn't stick out that far. So instead of, I need to do it the opposite way. I think I got most of the base stuff done. Let me push this in a little bit before I go further. I got a little bit more time I can spend on this before I gotta run. So let me see what else I can do. I'm gonna throw in the eyes and then start on the teeth. And then I'll come back and work on this. So again, a little later. Let's throw in the eyeballs. Thank you. think I'm, I haven't even added the eyes yet, but and I did all this work. I'm probably gonna have to do some more work. Well, of course I am. But let's turn this off for now. All right, so I got quite a bit done in this almost hour. Only thing I need to really work on is the teeth, the eye, adding the eyes, and adding some more details. And I'm gonna see if I want to add the other little, I want to say maybe like tattoos that he has on his skin. Outside of that, that's where I'm at for greed for right now. Gotta add the teeth and eyes. And then we can start working on some of the other details. Let me go here, because for some reason this color still doesn't quite get it. It could just be, it feels a little bit more blue, and I feel like I'm getting more green out of this. It is in the blue range. It's kind of desaturated though. We'll go with that color.